Hey guys, I'm Stan Wolf and welcome back to the channel. And this is nothing more than kind of me coming downstairs this morning and I just kind of felt like building a treehouse. I just felt like running. There's nothing more to this. I was just thinking, like, if anything, what if I, like, while we're waiting on the DLC announcement and the world not to end and all of kind of what's going on this last week or two, what if we just get in here and maybe do like a treehouse village? Like, you know, maybe this is just like we'll just take this as like the little starting person's house, and then I can branch off with little bridges and we could do like a grocery store, maybe a little medicine man's house. We could do like a water tower, and maybe that'll kind of just, you know, get us through maybe these next couple weeks as far as not knowing when new content is coming. And it, like I said, it'll give us something just little and fun and lighthearted to kind of mess with. Not, you know, obviously we're doing some big, you know, African themed treehouse. We're not taking ourselves too seriously here. Like I said, I think for the next actual zoo, we will wait until kind of all this passes over and we get DLC news and all that and decide where Frontier's going and all of that. But I still think there's a way we're going to be able to add animals, like even like down here on the ground level. What if I had make the exhibit, you know, hide it with rocks and trees and stuff and make it look like there's like a little an Indian elephant herd down here, kind of down on the ground level. I think there's a bunch of little fun stuff we could do with that. What I might do is I'll end up maybe removing this piece of fence right here and branch over to like maybe a market house. And like, I think maybe the whole story that we can go with on this is it's a treehouse village. Everything is up kind of off of the rainforest floor as much as possible. And then, like I said, we can try to incorporate the animals maybe as much as possible, or if we can come up with any neat tricks. But basically, this guy's little pad here is he lives back kind of like in the tree, and he's got all of his little supplies out here. He's got his little hanging branches. We've got some wind chimes over here. You've got one entrance kind of over here on this side of his house, and then the other door is over here on the right hand side. And I took this suspended high grazer. I was asking some people on Instagram. I said, what do you guys think about this suspended grazer as being like a little birdhouse, you know, like they could fly in and out and kind of use that as their little nest spots. Right here, I did kind of a crappy job. But you ever see like the little netting that's way up in the air? We've got this right here you can lay around on. I've got his hammock kind of suspended up here. We've got, you know, he's got just different little supplies laying around and stuff. And then I was actually able to use the East Asian cart as like a makeshift ladder that comes down here to the rock. And I figured the wheels could be almost like his pulley system. If he has something really heavy down here, we could, like, I think I'm gonna put some ropes that are going up on each side of the wheels, and he could use that to like hoist stuff up to his house, to supplies and stuff like that. And down here at the bottom, you know, I went a little crazy, flipped the trees. One thing that I really, you know, I have to give a big shout out to Cavity Creep and Mike for their gardening tips that they just did. Really, really cool video. I'll link it down below if you haven't got to check it out. But a lot of the stuff they were saying, like, I've implemented kind of with Planet Coaster, you know, all that over the years, but they have given me such a good refresh on why a lot of that stuff looks the way it does, and a lot of little tips and tricks, particularly with sinking the trees down into the ground to get that really cool, you know, bush-like effect. So I definitely recommend if you're struggling with some of your foliage themes and scenes, definitely go and give those guys a look on that video and see if you can kind of take anything out of it. Just detailing, I've got like these little charms and stuff kind of swaying in the wind up here on these two poles. So I kind of want to do that with each of the houses. You know, do like a different theme for each house. But you guys have to, what I want you to do is give me some ideas down below on some different services that you think a village would need. And I will try to, like we said, get some different little, like a little highway of bridges going that connect all of these houses and all of these services, and make it to where the people do not have to go down to the ground very, very often at all. So, like I said, I think this will be our kind of like, this will be the mischief maybe we'll get into here for the next couple weeks, or at least next week or two, until we start running out of ideas. But anyways, guys, yeah, don't forget to smash that like button if you end up enjoying this video, and let me know down below some services or some essential services you think a treehouse village would need to keep these people from having to come down and leave their treehouses. So yeah, don't forget to smash that like button, and don't forget to subscribe to keep up with more of this mischief. And yeah, I will catch you guys in the next video. We'll see where this goes. See ya.